Hello and welcome to this very special edition of the El Sanka Super Show on Amaze TV. We're coming to you live from our studios in London. It's a special edition mainly because we do not normally broadcast this particular program on a Thursday, but we're taking it today on a Thursday. And the second reason why it's actually special is because we have a particularly special guest on the show tonight. Before I actually introduce him to you, I would like to tell you an additional facility that we've already got in the studios tonight, which will give you an opportunity to interact with us. It is a phone-in facility. That means that you can call us, that you can talk to me, and you can call, also talk to my guest, whom when I tell you who he is, you will very soon be very delighted. The number that to call is 0207-274-2699. You'd be able to talk to me, and you'd also be able to talk to my guest. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's a very special day for me, and it's also a very special edition of the program, the El Sanka Super Show. Tonight on the program, we have a formidable artist from Sierra Leone, one who has made a really powerful mark on the musical industry of the country. I'm sure those of you who have heard his music would actually attest to this one, because his music is one that actually is most captivating. It has captivated me myself, and I'll tell you who it is. It's none other than Prince Kuti George. We all know him as Innocent, and he's a man who is in the studios with me tonight. Good afternoon to you, Innocent. Sure that's what you would like me to call you.
Yes, definitely.
Right. Can you tell us a little bit about when your musical career actually started?
Well, I could say my career started way beyond year 2000. But year 2000 was when I started doing secular music. So I could say I started officially in the year 2000.
I noticed really, I mean, when I heard your music, I noticed that it was actually one of those really very powerful ones that people cannot resist. But it's been taking the country by storm. How do you feel about a man like you coming up and then playing music which is taking the country by storm?
I actually feel good, you know, after so much hard work that I've actually been putting on this whole musical project. Me seeing people appreciating me, taking the whole country and beyond by storm, I feel overwhelmed, I'm happy, and I really feel blessed.
Well, you know what? I think the best thing to do is to give the people what actually we always say, the proof of the pudding lies in the eating. The first piece of music we're going to play is Namama Bon Me. But I'm sure you'd like to tell us what exactly is the inspiration behind this one.
Yeah, this song is actually a love song. The word Mama Bon Me is actually from a Sierra Leonean dialect, Creole.
Yeah.
And it simply means like, I was born by a woman. You know what I mean? I was born by my mother. You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, there is this woman that was not treating me well. And women are regarded as our sisters, as our mothers, and as our wives. And if I have a woman that is not treating me well, I was trying to actually apologize to her. Or I was like trying to put it plain to her, like she should realize that I was born by a woman and she is a woman too.
And then you will treat them with respect.
Yeah, you know, okay. So she should treat me like a son if I treat her like my mother.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, Innocent, that's very good to hear. Now, what I would say is Innocent will definitely like me to dedicate this piece of music, Namama Bon Me, to all the mothers around. Recently, I think, in fact, it was Sunday or so, it was Mother's Day in America.
And
recently, we've also celebrated Mother's Day in this country. So to all of you who are mothers, this is a special dedication as our first piece of music from Innocent Kuti.
school. Now because of you, don't say yes, me, I love you. Now that thing, so you are using like a tool. Treat me like say, I'm a marbon, yeah. Be safe, I'm a marbon, yeah. I'm a treat me like say, I'm a marbon, yeah. Sorry for me, I'm a marbon, yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. I'm sure you enjoyed that one. Innocent, now, I want to ask you this question. The first time I heard your name, I was wondering if you're related to Fela Ronsi in Nigeria. Have you got any connection with him at all?
Yeah, actually, yeah, I could say that because back in Sierra Leone, I am the only Kuti out there.
Yeah.
You know, because my dad, my granddad is from Nigeria.
Oh, right. Okay.
But my dad and I was born in Sierra Leone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, my dad was Kuti and my mom is George. So that's how I become Kuti George.
So would you say, therefore, that that musical inspiration may have come from that ancestry, perhaps?
Yeah, I could say it's from the lineage.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I could accept that because considering my dad was a musician also, he used to play saxophone.
Okay.
Yeah, and when you think about Ransom Aniku Lapo Fela Kuti, he is a master of saxophone. Yeah, so there is this connection, really.
You play musical instruments.
Yes, well, I play saxophone, I play keyboard.
All right.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, now the next piece of music we're going to play is one I'm sure we've got ready, which is number 2 on our list. And this one is much quicker in terms of its pace than Namama Bonmi. So we're going to go straight to this track, which is also by Innocent Kuti, and it's called Sofa Posh.
He dey suffer, he dey make posh. This lifestyle, yeah, it's too dangerous. My love go to pick and bail bus. Snap and people motor car, put on a status. He dey suffer, but he make posh. Yeah, yeah. How about you feel say we I say they oversee where you catch na Lagos? Suffer posh, Baba show you na suffer posh. Suffer posh, always till you dey talk na slush. Suffer posh, baby show you na suffer posh. Suffer posh, my max be holy, the lights in a flush. Speak English by one kinda we fun. Never pull angry, pana chingom. Go to all my weight, guess fine I be done. From A to foot, if you check fine a chinchong. Na Facebook, you na Chantel. But who you kinda host, you na Yabo. Instagram, you na Larry. But who you kinda host, na Gbanagbo. Where's the makeup, all na Shinka. Dolly Sinamo, Lala Pinta. Who's the money, go to Africa. You papa na Popo Kapinta. You dey suffer, you dey make posh. This lifestyle, yeah, it's too dangerous. Man off go to pick and bail bus. Snap and people motor car, put on a status. You dey suffer, but you make posh. Yeah, yeah. How about you feel say we I say you say oversee where you catch na Lagos? Suffer posh, Baba show you na suffer posh. Suffer posh, always till you dey talk na slush. Suffer posh, baby show you na suffer posh. Suffer posh, my max be holy, the lights in a flush. Bakuma no begin come on gear. No be snow with t-shirt beer. The map the post pass a gear for money ni no eat. Must be a. If he pull the makeup, Sam na babu. The face need construction, one man a boo. Bobo in chain na in neck, San kama hu. And then me boss can beat me, come na da woo. Na me tucker, Fela Kuti. Chinese clothes, like na Gucci. Fireborn, like na boutique. Ringwell water, like na tutik. He dey suffer, he dey make posh. This is lifestyle, yeah, it's too dangerous. Man off go to pick and bail bus. Snap and people motor car, put on a status. He dey suffer, but he make posh. Yeah, yeah. How about you feel say we I say say oversee where you catch na Lagos? Suffer posh, Baba show you na suffer posh.
Welcome back to the El Sanka Super Show on Amaze TV, and thank you very much for watching. We're going to continue the show. This time I am going to have to continue the interview with Innocent. As I say, we've got him exclusive from the from Sierra Leone. And we have decided that as we have captured him up this time, and we're not sure we're going to be able to get him another time, it is just important that we get him live to you so that you enjoy the music that he has played. And Ben, he can tell you exactly the background to the music that he's been playing. We're now going to talk quickly about the next piece of music that we are going to play, which is actually called DNA. Now, what is the story behind DNA?
And DNA is actually the foundation of creation, you know what I mean? from my own point of view. And I believe every human being is genetically connected to your mom or to your dad. You know what I mean? So at the end of the day, when I decided to do the song DNA, I was telling this woman that she is in my DNA. You know what I mean? There is actually a trace of our genetic trace inside of me. You know, so that's why I actually titled this song DNA. It's for the ladies and every beautiful lady out there. This song is dedicated to you. And it was a banger, it was a super hit.
Right. Yeah. Okay, innocent. I mean, what I have noticed from the interview as it's going at the moment is the fact that a good number of your tracks are dedicated to ladies. Why is that?
Well, I'm actually a ladies' man. There is this saying, behind every successful man, there must be a woman. You know what I mean? And when God created us, He actually said, after I've made man, let me make you an helpmate. So women are actually our helpmates. They are there to support us, to guide us, to uplift us. So I'm actually I'm a woman person.
Okay, if I can take you up on that, and that is your statement that behind every successful man, there is a woman. So can you tell us a little bit about the woman who is behind this success of yours?
Yeah. I was actually blessed to be married to a very beautiful, a very humble, a very supporting woman. You know, I think she's the one that actually motivated me or moved me to this country. Yeah, if you're watching, special shout out to my wife, Adumakuti George. Enough respect.
Well, we'll make sure that this record is actually dedicated to her.
Yeah.
Well, if whatever, what's her name again?
Adama.
Adama, this is a record that is dedicated to you, and Innocent has actually asked for this to be done for you. And I'm sure you should be happy if you, wherever you are, get up and start dancing to this one.
You go tell me, Papa, and you go tell me, family. Say, I'm a family diamond. And you go tell me, Pastor.
Fine. No rival, no Christmas line. This one make them check like them taste palm wine. I for carry the check quick, make a sign.
The picture where you take and find. No rival, no Christmas line. This one make them check like them taste palm wine. I for carry the check quick, make a sign.
I've been searching. Searching for your love.
What I want to ask you, is what has actually motivated you to come into music rather than take up another trade?
I was actually a born artist. Before singing, I was actually drawing. I was a painter before I started singing. And it actually reached to some point wherein I was going to church. It was the Door Christian Fellowship Church in Ferry Junction. I started going to church and I joined this gospel musical group wherein I started playing the seven drum and I started learning to play keyboard. I was actually inspired or moved by the praise and worship in the church, you know what I mean? And it actually motivated me and I decided like, I need to start. And when I started, I found out that I was doing well because I was being called upon every performance. And I went back home and when I was actually alone and I figured out that I'm actually a musician though.
Now that's interesting. The other thing that I really wanted to ask you is the fact that Sierra Leone is very well known for high life and Maringa music, but you seem to have gone away from that and you have a completely different genre. Now why is that? And what is the genre?
I actually started from Maringa music. I just happened to, as the musical trend is evolving, I just happened to upgrade it to the modern day Afrobeat.
Right.
Yeah, so for now I could say I'm an Afrobeat artist. But when we started, it was Marenge music, because that's what Sierra Leone is known for, just as you just said earlier on. I upgraded it to Afrobeat because I wanted to match up with the rest of the world. You know what I mean? Africa is taking up the banner for music, and presently Afrobeat is evolving with some kind of speed, and I feel like I should join because I'm actually talented enough. I could blend in, I could compose like all the other African artists. I feel like it's time for me to blend in, and that's why I'm actually blending in. That's why I changed the genre from Marenge to Afrobeat.
Well, it actually seems to have shown a lot of creativity in you, a lot of originality, as some of the music that you have played actually shows. Now, the next thing perhaps I would like you to tell us is, who would you say was your musical idol? Somebody who perhaps you might have been imitating, somebody whose footsteps you might want to follow?
Most of the, like I should say, in Sierra Leone, one of the people that actually inspired or motivated me is Steady Bongo. Yeah, and funnily, most of the times when I say it in interviews, people are like, what? Yeah, it was Steady Bongo. Because when I did my very first hit song in the year 2000, Igwe, which was a very big hit, it was the one that actually showed me how to do shows, how to tour. And it was like, boy, come here, let me talk to you. This old music thing, you're only going to make money if you're touring. And he took me to Bo. It was the very first time that I went to Bo. And I stormed the whole place. And that was how I knew it's not just about singing the music, it's about touring and making money from the music, because the Bible says a man's talent maketh room for him. So yeah, Steady is actually one of my biggest motivators, and I could call him an icon and idol too. And another person is Fela Kuti, the late Fela Kuti, Ransom Anikulapo Fela Kuti, the king of Afrobeat. He actually inspires me a whole lot. And another person again is Steady Bongo, because he was the one that actually went down to Sierra Leone after doing a whole lot in South Africa. He went down in Sierra Leone and he was like, it's time you guys should start singing in your local dialect. You know, he was the one that brought about the awareness that so that Sierra Leonean artists could realize that if we sing in our languages, music is actually a universal language. You could sing in Mende, Timini, Loko, Limba, and at the end of the day, it will cut across as long as the melody is nice.
Well, I've always believed that, really, that music doesn't have any particular language. The language itself is that music, and as long as you enjoy it, you can dance to it. I mean, after all, when we were younger, we always learned the music of people like Nico, Dr. Nico, and we knew all the fishes and crystals, would learn them off by heart, and we couldn't even understand it. Even up to this time, I don't even understand it at all,
exactly.
But I still enjoyed it.
Exactly.
So that actually shows how creative people like you are. So we do appreciate that. Well, the other thing that perhaps we might now come to is how your message actually resonates with people in the country. How do people receive your music in the country? And perhaps I could say, let's talk this one, Yanakrio. Then check the way they talk about how they check they receive your music and how then they respond to you. And if Adam are not jealous at all, tell me about.
Okay, I like that. And the people are really, they receive the music with open hands, considering I didn't have the eastern part of Sierra Leone. Now they are born, now they are attend Methodist Boys High School, now they are raised up. And me music actually, they be influenced by the community. Now what in person they talk, what in person they say, or what here, now here they put on the music. So everybody they see himself inside the music. So every time when I release a new song, people and they wait for Yeri, what you know, saying they can't talk. Especially when I can talk about the situation. As a very good musician, you always put yourself in the position of the people. You know, if you want to talk about Mano and Broken Heart, you for put yourself in the position first. That kind of emotional response, now they create that kind of scene for make the person where they listen and self able for feel say, really, people like saying, I mean, this guy they talk about. Who. So the music now, thing where people can welcome with open hands. I believe say people and they way then they live on the message. Especially when it comes to inspiration, it comes to inspiring people. You know what I mean? When I they explain about me life, why they explain about my story, my story inside my music, they inspire people. Some people can message me, they tell me, say, Innocent, this song we just released, so they make her believe, say, me, I must make an alive. Me, as long as I work hard, I must achieve what I have to achieve. You know, so my music na part of every Sierra Leonean their life. And like come to the ladies them. The ladies them really, they can relate, you know, with the young boyfriend. Not like me, oh, because as I say earlier on, the music then they put themselves by the position. So imagine song like DNA, if woman want for sing unto a man, me not go did it, but then they put themselves at the position of me, because me say don't put me say at the position of them. So even one another, they relate na the relationship.
Okay, where this Teddy Bongo are, yeah, where take you go, boy? You been play any music for them where, inside Mende or something? Because a couple people there, na boo, then na Mende them. So you been play any music for them inside Mende?
Well, really, when I go na boo song the very first time, that was literally not a song where I do in Mende. But later on, because the very first time I go, the song where I go with na Igwe, it was a very big hit in Sierra Leone by then. And after a while, when I begin the tour, I begin go bo, I go Kenema, Shegbema, Daru, Bunumbu, Penembu, Boedu, say go na the Koindu. I can't develop an idea where in a slang, where every side where you go, within that Mende line there, then they use that word, the Banya Feki. So I can't record a song where I call Banya Feki. It was a very big hit. And I've been on the tour. When I return back, the song starts a new, fresh story again. Everybody begin to call me because of just the word Banya Feki. You know, so now that kind of way I've been able for benefit where steady be introduced me to that part of the country. The Mendes, now people were very welcoming by then. And they were actually relating to that particular song.
I don't know if na combination of English or Creole with Mende, Banya Feki, Banya Mende, no fake me.
Yeah, exactly.
And, our people that they fake their company and the country.
Exactly, because you know, the women on that particular side, they were like, Mande, Mande na this side, na boku talk den ge, where den can make this, I go do this for you, I go do that for you, I go make so for you. Utaya for yegi den, where den de, Banya Feki, you know why yegi again. So like them blend, the thing is, I was like, I asked somebody, I said, Banya na noka, Feki na like fake me.
Yeah.
You know, I was like, because if I use the entire Mende word, I don't know. I mean, they think and say, maybe you're not going to be able to relate that much. Laughing something English or Creole, blend that with the Mende word. So Banya and Feki, it sounds very funny. It's just like Sofa Posh. Sofa and Posh. You understand? I mean, a Posh making bang words together for like able to achieve one goal. So I didn't know the idea. I was like, Banya, okay, Feki. Blend them together. It can form as a very unique slang. We're able to train another part of
so
the country.
So you didn't say the chick then, now, don't, smart.
Yeah, now the bouncer and they take Banya Feki again.
Oh, really? Okay. Okay. Well, we did say that we have a special facility, an additional facility to the XL Sanka Super Show, which you can use if you wish. And that is a phone in, which number is 0207-274-2699. And as I say, right now, live in the studios, we have Innocent, who would like to talk to you, if you want to talk to him. And you can talk to me as well. Can ask for perhaps any kind of music that you want Innocent to play. Of course, it's going to be his own piece of music that he would like to play for you. So if you want to call in for that, that's fine. We have it's 0207-274-2699. Now, the next piece of music we're going to play is one that I would think resonates with everybody in the country, because at this time, from all the news that we hear from the country, it is not as stable as it should be. And therefore, there would be many people who are not particularly happy at what is going on. But we'll talk a little bit about that after we've heard the music from Innocent. It is Udat Responsible. We'll talk about that after the piece of music. And that is Udat Responsible.
Salon for better, salon for crow, la Udat Responsible. Il a me responsible, I say. On are you responsible? Everybody say. Now we all responsible. Now we need good things, then we're sensible. If you need a sleep, it's not self awake by your team. Now we face reality, because this year not to fame. See what talk say, I don't see.
And you young dirty fussy for clean. You no want for work like a slave, but you want for it like a king. Hey, Salomon, so neck ready made. How you go get work, but you no land trade. You no land cook, you no get talent, and you need. But you want for sleep, now what's a bed. You know they study, but you want pass. You dey get great when you come again a class. Hope you yes, and listen to me fast. You go fever like you dey see yourself my class.
Salon for better, salon for crow, now who da responsible? Salon for better, salon for crow, now who da responsible? You and me responsible, or now you responsible? Everybody say, now we all responsible. Now we dey do things that way sensible.
A small thing happen so, wanna be give for point finger. You keep you young, a box for the boss in the young. You pull on a window, then they begin blame Timini. Then lock up, begin blame Limba. Before we black, they blame them juice. Well, let juice back, we blame ginger. We kiss a bit for identify the problem, but we not kiss a bit find the solution. You wait fat to fat, now you back one gumble, but he a pollution. As then give you money for shady, go shape small. Now the rest, he go put some. Politician demo, citizen demo. We all now don't make fat collusion.
Thank you very much, and welcome back to the El Sanka Super Show on Amaze TV. My guest tonight, of course, as you know, is Prince Kuti George, otherwise known as Innocent. I hope you enjoyed that piece of music. I really enjoyed it myself, although I have to admit that my favorite record by Innocent is actually coming at the end, because we always say, leave the best for last. That's my best, and that's one of the reasons why exactly I kept it last. For now, I just want to talk to Innocent about the reasoning behind that track. What is the reasoning behind that track? Why did you actually play that? Were you trying to reflect the situation in the country at the time? Because this is not actually, you didn't actually do this at this time.
Yeah, I actually did it a while ago. And the thing about me, maybe it's actually a gift of sight, or what should I call it?
Foresight.
Yeah. Because most of these things were not happening like the way it's actually happening now, but I was actually feeling a glimpse of it, you know, and I decided to do this song because I want every Sierra Leonean to understand that we should not be casting blame on each other. You know, for a country to go forward, I think it's a collective responsibility. You know, we should put aside the blame game, or we should put aside tribalism, regionalism, or sectionalism. And because most of these things are actually things that propped about violence, you know what I mean? So I think we should be putting all these stuffs behind us. And as Sierra Leoneans, let's actually embrace Sierra Leone as one country, and let's forget about Party A, Party B, Party C, Party D, because Sierra Leone is one country, and we should actually be unified. We should actually embrace it, so that at the end of the day, we will have a better country.
It is actually a very, very important and relevant message for this part of the world, and also particularly for Sierra Leone.
You know, every Sierra Leonean has this mentality, like, they will be blaming Mr. A or Mr. B or Mr. C. They will be blaming government. Government will be blaming them. It's just the blame thing, you know what I mean? And at the end of the day, we don't need that at this point.
Okay. Under normal circumstances on this program, one of the things we do is to get our guests to look at their camera, which is that camera there, okay, and to actually talk to the people of Sierra Leone or your fans, to let them know exactly what they have to do to bring in progress in that country and advancement as well. Something that we have been looking for a long, long time. So if you look in that camera and then talk to them directly, motivate them as to what exactly they have to do to create progress in that country. That's your camera.
Okay, let me use this medium here. Sierra Leone is the only country that we have. Sierra Leone is our motherland. We should embrace ourselves, put every issue aside, the issue of revenge, the issue of regionalism, the issue of sectionalism, the issue of tribalism, the issue of sabotage. Let's put everything behind us and let's actually embrace and work towards a better Sierra Leone, because we're actually making Sierra Leone a better place for our kids, you know what I mean? So let's put violence aside, let's embrace ourselves, let's embrace Sierra Leone, because that's the only country that we have.
Well, you know what I'm saying here? What the reason why this message has to be taken seriously is because Innocent does not give me any impression at all that he is sectionalist, that he belongs to this particular area or this particular person or this particular party or anything like that. He's actually talking to you directly as a Sierra Leonean, and that is one reason why his music resonates with me, and I expect that it will resonate with everybody in that country. And I believe you, me, the piece of music we're going to play now is one that will be absolutely relevant for circumstances like this in this country, in the world today, in Sierra Leone, and believe you me, every part of the globe. This piece of music is the first that I actually listened to from Innocent, which captivated my heart. I am sure it is going to captivate your heart. And believe you me, let's pray. Pray for me. Innocent, here we go.
Innocent.
Hey, let me say for everybody.
Money making machine. Worldwide.
Boy, I pray for me. Mama, pray for me. I'm in the jungle. I want to make money. Boy, I pray for me. Papa, pray for me. Oluwa, guide my footsteps in this journey. Boy, I pray for me.
Pray, pray. Thank you very much, and welcome back to the Elsanka Super Show on Amaze TV. Now, I have to say to you, Innocent, that that is a music that actually captivated me as one of your fans. I love that music, and believe you me, there is not a time that it resonates with people more than this this time in Sierra Leone, in the United States, in Britain, all over the world, where we have this unprecedented virus which actually is destroying human lives. So of course we need a lot of prayers. What I want you to do for me now, I want you to tell me how we can get you, in other words, when next perhaps you have any kind of gig that people would want to attend, and maybe how they can contact you. Can you let us know that, please?
Well, actually, I'm not planning on any event at present because of the coronavirus, you know what I mean? We could not figure out when it's gonna end. But to actually keep people waiting is bad as a musician. So while people are isolated, while people are on lockdown, I am about to release a song that I actually titled Notomi Portion. It's going to be an audio and a video release, and by the grace of God, inshallah, it's going to be out by the end of this month. So everybody should just log on and check out Innocent Kuti, which is my Facebook page. And of course, official_innocent_Kuti is my Instagram. This song is going to be out very soon. It's going to be actually a double banger. Notomi Portion, which is like a Pray For Me, but it's the big brother of Pray For Me. And Savage, which is like DNA, but it's actually a big brother of DNA. You know what I mean? So people should just log on, get ready. These songs are going to be coming very soon. And by the grace of God, before I put them out, I am going to be here at Amaze TV and talk about it before we release it.
Right. The other thing we do on this program is to ask our guests to dedicate a piece of music, which perhaps might be, again, Pray For Me, which is my favorite.
Okay.
And why do they do that? It is to show appreciation and gratitude to those people who, behind the scenes, have actually helped you to move forward, to make progress. Can you now think of those people who behind the scenes have actually helped you to become what you are? And when you have your programs, what do they do? What inspiration do they give you? These are the people. Perhaps if you have their names right now, you can actually mention them.
Okay.
That means we'll dedicate this piece of music to them. And that last music, which is my favorite, as I said, I hope it becomes your favorite, everybody else out there. Pray For Me is going to be the one that we're going to be praying. So we'll be playing. And therefore, now, your camera again, do that for us.
Okay. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. It's been a pleasure, you know, to be in the Amaze TV today. And I actually wanted to use this platform to send a special dedication to my people, my personal people. You know what I mean? First of all, you know what I mean? Me, Alekumanbad. And it started with me with.
Well, not Alekumanbad, they let me with.
A special shout out to my wife, you know what I mean? Adwa Kuti George, aka Adino. Yeah, special shout out to you and to my mom. She actually happens to be my mother-in-law, but she's my mom.
Okay, right.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Maratu Anderson, enough respect. And of course, to my manager, you know what I mean? The man behind the movement and everything. But he's got a whole lot of names. He's Ahmed Bangura, he's Donald Bangura, he's Bololo. You know?
Right.
He's got a whole lot of names, yeah. And of course, I want to use this opportunity to send special shout out to every DJ in the UK. Every DJ in the UK, you know what I mean? I have so much respect and love for you guys because you guys have been doing a whole lot. And of course, every colleague artist in the UK, you know what I mean? You guys are my family. Let's do this. Let's push this together. And at the end of the day, together, everyone achieves more. That is what team is all about. You know what I mean? And especially to my brethren, SS1. And of course, if I'm going to be calling, I'm definitely going to be calling everyone in the UK. You know what I mean? Enough respect to Spratly Charity Foundation. I see you, my brother, man, King Z. Enough respect, family. And of course, to my graphic designer, he's watching me all the way from Australia.
Wow.
Who is Golden Ray. You know what I mean? I feel you, bro. You know you've been there from day one. And of course, Alaji Production all the way from United States of America. Thank you, and without you guys, this old innocent would not have been really, really possible.
Okay, so thank you very much, and therefore the best music that we can actually play for an occasion like
Excuse
this.
Excuse me, yeah. Why would I even come? Why didn't I even start from Amaze TV?
That's fine. We don't mind. I mean, the fact that you're here.
I don't know. I should start from Amaze TV.
Okay, that's
definitely
fine.
For you, Mr. Dabo, for my man JJ in the building. You know what I mean?
Right. No.
Without you guys, this would not have been possible. You know what I mean?
We understand that the fact you're here alone is a sense of appreciation for us. So we appreciate that.
You didn't even have to mention us.
That's absolutely fine. So I can ask the producers there, Imad. Imad, can you give us this piece of music that I was talking about earlier? Pray For Me, please. That's going to be the last one that we will play for this program.
Money making my sin. Worldwide.
Oh yeah, pray for me. Mama, pray for me. I'm in the jungle. I want to make money. Oh yeah, pray for me. Papa, pray for me. Oluwa, guide my footsteps in this journey. Boy, I pray for me.
Pray, 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 pray,
bless me as I am taking this journey. Road to success, not be something we funny. Sometimes you go day level, sometimes you go stormy. Lord, I depend on you to prepare a table before me.
No.
Baba, take me away.
Oh, thank you very much for listening to that piece of music. I hope you've enjoyed the whole show just as much as I've enjoyed presenting it. And I have to say, I've been most delighted at this interview with Innocent, which has actually been very, very revealing and very, very enjoyable. So I want to say thank you very much to you again, Innocent, and everybody who actually helps you to enjoy whatever you're doing and to make progress there. So to all of you there, we apologize for the fact that we've been off the air for some time, but that is because of these unprecedented circumstances that we are in at this right time. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, from the El Sanka Super Show, at the Amaze TV. I want to say thank you very much for having listened to us, and we look forward to you joining us next Friday when we have the program at the same time, and most probably we might have a repeat of this program, especially for those people who have missed it, because this is an outstanding artist who you should actually listen to more and more. So it's most likely that you'll have a repeat of this program at the normal time that we have our El Sanka Super Show. Thank you very much for watching. Once again, from me and from my producers, Imad and James, and everybody in the studios, and to you, Innocent, I want to say thank you very much for watching, and goodbye.
You're watching.